Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel Basic of ServiceNow Learning. So in today's video we will explore G underscore scratchpad. So first we will see what is G underscore scratchpad and then we will do a practical implementation of it. So let's see first what is G underscore scratchpad. So G underscore scratchpad object is used to pass information from the server to the client, such as when the client requires information which is not available on the form. So let's see the form first. This is my ServiceNow developer personal instance. So let's navigate to some form. I'm navigating to the incident form, clicking on open and opening any of the form. So I am opening this form. So we already have some information into it. Okay, like number, caller, category, subcategory, business service, impact, state, contact type, assignment group, priority, right? If we know that what information the client needs from the server before the form gets loaded, then in a display business rule, we can create G underscore scratchpad properties to hold the required information. So let's see practically how we can implement it, how we can hold the information in display business rule under G underscore scratchpad, and how we can use that G underscore scratchpad object in a client script or any method of the client. Let's move to the ServiceNow application again. So what I have to do first, we have to create a display business rule. Friend, to do all this type of stuff, we always need an admin role. Okay, so to write a business rule, to write a client script, we need an admin role. So I click on the business rule over here. Let's create a new business rule. We can give any name to a business rule, like table should be incident because we will implement some functionality into incident. Okay, first, we have not figured out the functionality yet, that what functionality we have to implement. So to figure out the functionality, I am navigating to the incident again. So see, we have a caller name over here, and so what we will do, and we don't have an attachment over here. Okay, so what we will do, we will implement a functionality that if the incident ticket has an attachment. So the functionality is that if the incident has attachment, then it will pop up a alert message to us, which will be having a caller email ID. Okay, so see, we don't have a data over here that we can confirm that we have attachment or not, or we don't have a caller's email ID anywhere in this form. So what we will do, we will fetch this information from the server and store it in under a G underscore scratchpad object, and then we will use that particular G underscore scratchpad object in a client script or a client methods. Let's see how. So we already have a business rule which we were creating earlier. So I named it as scratchpad business rule, table incident, when to run. So click on advanced first. When to run, we have to create a display business rule. Okay, now what message we can, or what information we can get from the server to get information, I should write scratchpad dot, we have to get an email ID, right? Current dot, so this caller ID field name is call underscore ID. Okay, underscore ID, and we should get, we need an email of that caller ID, right? Okay, and we have to check that that form have a attachment or not. So we have created the business rule, display business rule for incident table. Now we have to create a client script. So we can use a display business rule in any method of the client. So here I am creating a change on change client script, giving any name, scratchpad client, table is incident, type is on change. Okay, this code snippet is automatically populated by ServiceNow. So on the change of category, I believe we can implement it. Okay, so what message we, what code we have to write over here, like if g underscore scratchpad dot has attachments, right? This one. So if g underscore scratchpad has attachments, then alert email ID, right? Yes. Okay, else alert . So here we implement the client script where we have written that if the g underscore scratchpad, or we can say if the form has attachment, then it will alert us a message that email ID of a caller is, we are getting this email ID from the display business rule. Okay. Or if that there is no attachment in the form, then it will provide us an alert that there is no attachment in the incident form. So I am saving this. So we have a client script and we have a business rule. Let's execute it in the form. We already have a form. We don't have attachment over here. I am reloading it and changing the category because we have implemented it on change. We can also implement it on load. Okay. So I clicked on software and changed the category to hardware. Then it displayed as a message that no attachment in this form because this form does not have any attachment. So let's take a form which have a attachment. Let's navigate to incident. I think this is having attachment. Okay, click on this. See this form having attachment. So when I change the category, it display as a email caller's email ID, that approver user second@gmail.com. That is the email ID of a caller. So friends, in this way we can achieve this functionality, or we can implement g underscore scratchpad, but we have to make sure that we can use g underscore scratchpad under display business rule or in the workflows. Okay, so there are actually two places where we can use the g underscore scratchpad, in display business rule and other in the workflow. So friends, let's recall it again that we can use g underscore scratchpad when we need some information from the server, or we can say that g underscore scratchpad pass information from a server to the client. We can use g underscore scratchpad in two places. The first in display business rule and the second is in workflow. Actually, in display business rule, g underscore scratchpad holds the information, and then that information we use in a client methods. So friend, this is all for this video. I hope this video help you to understand g underscore scratchpad. So if you like this video, please do subscribe my channel and please click on bell icon so you will receive my future videos notifications. Thank you friends, bye bye, have a nice day.